Hi, I'm John Cash. Welcome to John Cash Ministries, your daily devotional. One short verse from the book of Psalms 119 and verse 81. The Bible says, "My soul faints with longing for your salvation, but I have put my hope in your word." Folks, in this particular psalm, this is really a good foundational message for understanding what it means to be a Christian and what it means to have a relationship with God. Because in the end, Christianity, yes, it's a major world religion, but in a way, it's not a religion, it's a relationship with God. And this verse describes it well, because it says, "My soul faints with longing for your salvation." And we're going to focus a moment on faints with longing. What does that mean, to faint with longing for your salvation? Obviously, there is a very strong emotional connection between the writer of this psalm and God Almighty. And this is what God wants from us, a very strong emotional connection. Now, he doesn't want us to view him with just raw emotionalism, but he wants us to have an emotional connection, a soulful connection, a spiritual connection with him. And so it says, "My soul faints with longing." Let me ask you something. What do you long after? Do you long after power? Do you long after prestige, money, an easy life, a big house, nice car, perfect family life? I mean, what do you long for? A long life. What do you really long for? What do you want more than anything else? Here, the writer says he longed for salvation. Salvation. Now, that's got multiple meanings to it. One, salvation of the soul, where we know where we're going to be when we die. We should be longing for that, to be with God forever in eternity. He is our creator. Look, I know evolutionists will say, you know, evolution's real, blah, blah, blah. Folks, but the bottom line is it's junk science. In the end, God created everything. He's the creator. And he longs, God longs, to have a relationship with us, a one based on truth. And so he wants us to faint with longing for his salvation. This is also another meaning, the salvation, if you're in trouble, you're going through difficulties, you know, we're longing for him to come and save us, to fix us, to make things right. Maybe you're being persecuted. You can long for the salvation to make things right. Then the Bible says, "But I have put my hope in your word." So where do you put your hope in the end, folks? Do you put your hope in your own intelligence? Do you put your hope in your understanding of who God is? And you may be wondering, well, where did I really get my concept of God? Well, you have to get it. I mean, if you want it to be truthful, you needed to get it from the source of truth, which is the Bible. So he says, "But I put my hope in your word." And that's what he wants for us. He wants us to put our hope in his word, the Bible. Okay? So the Bible is where we get wisdom to learn how to live life. The Bible is where we get power to do what God wants us to do. The Bible is where we learn faith. So the Bible is the place that we go to truly get everything we need to get to know God better and to live the kind of life that God wants us to live. And so the writer of the Psalms here, when he says, "My soul faints with longing for your salvation, I have put my hope in your word," there is a connection between longing for his salvation and putting our trust in his word. Folks, if we don't put our trust in his word in the Bible, it will be practically impossible for us to long after him. The Bible says that as the deer panteth for the water, my soul panteth for you. So just picture, lastly here, picture a deer that's famished and is very thirsty and needs water and can't find it. And the deer knows, "I'm about ready to die." And then he finds the water, he's got it, and he's going to survive. It's that kind of thing where the Bible is the water, and we're longing for him and his word, knowing that is how we survive in this cruel, dark world. And that's how we're going to survive Judgment Day. And that's where we're going to transfer from this world to eternity with Jesus Christ.